Right from its first republic, the Nigerian people have had to deal with issues related to leadership. At a point, some politicians could barely coexist in the face of differences. One of the political unrest that is hardly talked about but remains unforgettable in the political annals of Nigeria is the Operation Wet Hear, which is translated as Operation Wet Him or Her. The country was fresh from independence, and for various reasons, violence had become a somewhat constant feature in politics, especially in the western parts of the country. It was particularly common even among people of the same region. Politicians and some supporters became victims of gruesome murders. They were wet with petrol, laced with tires, and burnt alive. Some historians hold the impression that Operation Wet Hear played a role in what became Nigeria's first military coup.
Our enemies are the political profiteers, the swindlers, the men in high and low places that seek bribes and demand 10%. Those that seek to keep the country divided permanently so that they can remain in office as ministers or VIPs at least. The tribalists, the nepotists, those that make the country look big for nothing before international circles. Those that have corrupted our society and put the Nigerian political calendar back by their words and deeds.
Major Kaduna Nzeogwu played a major role in Nigeria's first coup. According to him, the aim was to get the country back on the right track. However, the words he spoke are just as valid now, 55 years later. In fact, some people who were around at the time say things were even better then. Within a 27-year period, the country had at least 9 coups. The excuse for them was that the new regime was coming in to give the order, transparency, and development that previous regimes could not deliver. Interestingly, even now that the country is under democratic leadership, many of the people who were involved in these coups that were supposed to better the country are still major stakeholders in Nigeria's politics. Yet, the standard of living for the average Nigerian does not seem to get any better. According to the Human Development Reports by the United Nations Development Programme, 46.4% of Nigerians live in multidimensional poverty. Out of the 189 countries accounted for on the Human Development Index ranking, the giant of Africa stands at 161. To be fair, some indices indicate that the country has not merely been at a standstill. However, the pace of economic growth fails to match Nigeria's growing population, and leaders don't seem to acknowledge the need for a more vibrant and diversified economy. As of 1999, the country's population stood at 119 million. Now it stands at over 200 million. Conversely, the GDP growth rate went from 11.9% in the 1990s to 1.5% in the late 2010s. For a country experiencing demographic fatigue, these numbers don't help matters. According to the World Bank, 40% of Nigerians, that's about 83 million people, live below the poverty line, while another 25%, that's about 53 million, are vulnerable. When you add Nigeria's dependency on oil for foreign revenue to its population fatigue, the lack of political will to steer the country towards change, the ethnic and religious differences sewn into the fabric of the country, corruption, which reportedly permeates most sectors of life there, one starts to wonder what can be done to salvage the country. We'll be looking into that in our next and final episode on Nigeria. To join the conversation, do use the hashtag NCTheFuss. As always, thank you very much for watching.